conference championship season is right around the corner in NCAA gymnastics. And we've got a Sunday afternoon quad meet for you from McGonigal Hall. So good to have you with us today, everybody, alongside Lauren Capone Porzio. I'm Andrew Luffglass, and we've got two different conferences doing battle today with 2 weeks left to go for the Eagles, for Temple, as well as LIU, and the GECs are right around the corner for William & Mary in Westchester.
Yeah, just one more regular season weekend after this. All four teams today are kind of coming off an earlier in the week meet today, and so we're going to see some sort of double dual action within this quad meet today as we head into the final week of regular season gymnastics.
Well, let's talk about these four teams, and we'll start with Temple in their senior week and senior day. Hillary Steele leading the Owls in her first season. Here's a look at her resume, taking over for longtime head coach Josh Nielsen, who's on to the associate head coach role at Illinois. Hillary, a former standout with the Gym Dogs in Georgia, 2008 and 2009 NCAA champion with the Bulldogs, and of course that 2011 SEC Vault Individual Championship, and had a run with USA Gymnastics national team as well. Lauren, she's got to be pretty happy with how this team performed in their meet earlier this week. Their second 195 plus in the last three meets.
Exactly, yeah. Had an earlier home meet on Thursday of this past week. They went up against a couple other Eagle competitors at that meet as well and put out a pretty solid all-around performance. Definitely still some areas to improve on today, which will be great. That, I think, number one being vault. It was their lowest, you know, team event score of the day on Thursday, but not for any major mistakes, just looking for some better landings, which we're fighting for already as Amelia Budd kicks things off over on vault for the Owls.
Yeah, Temple will be on vault, as you mentioned, to start, and for Amelia Budd, with that Yurchenko full, Hillary Steele talking about how she's been working on those landings. Big improvement for her on Thursday, landed chest up. She'd been landing chest down for a lot of this season. On bars, LIU, Sid Morris in leadoff spot.
Yeah, so as you mentioned, this sort of double duel, LIU over on bars, also an Eagle team. So we'll be looking sort of at the Temple versus LIU meet within the meet, and then the Tribe of William & Mary over on floor going up against Westchester, who is currently on beam following a huge meet on Friday night where they actually set a new school record on beam. So great that we're seeing this event kick off for the Golden Rams over on beam, coming off of their night on Friday.
Very strong start there for Natalie Marshall on beam, and for Sid Morris with an excellent start on bars for LIU. They're coming off of a season high 9.9 on Sunday, a season high in the all-around 39.4. Hannah Burke starting on floor for William & Mary. That Westchester beam performance just on Friday against William & Mary, that program record 49.15, all five of their counting scores were career high performances.
Temple on vaults. Another Yurchenko full. Huge height, huge distance, just a hop back. As you mentioned, Andrew, Coach Hillary Steele was focused on those vault landings. You know, I don't think it was, they went 6 for 6 on Thursday. It was just a matter of the judging being super tight and maybe not being in that 9.8 plus range that they were hoping for. But she did mention the landings, as you said. You know, those little things will add up, especially when it comes to an Eagle championship.
Yeah, Hillary was saying she had to tell her gymnasts in that vault lineup, hey, you did your job on Thursday. Do that again coming up on Sunday and hope that the judging, the scoring isn't quite so tight. And the first two spots in this lineup today have looked pretty good with Budd and Monk coming up to the third spot in this LIU bar lineup, rather the second spot with Kate Parks. This is an LIU lineup that was quite good in their last meet on Sunday under fourth-year head coach Randy Lane. 49 plus for the first time this season. This is the only team in this quad, by the way, LIU, that has a long layoff. Everybody else competed either Thursday or Friday this week as Kate Parks gets started. And you see McCarthy Keene on beam for Westchester, bottom left.
Great triple series over on beam. Gets the gymnasts some extra bonus points when they do, you know, more than just the one handspring layout step out. Had a second handspring in there.
Little stumble by Parks on the landing, and now here's Hannah Weckler on vault for Temple.
Yurchenko layout half. Took that big step, so there will be that landing deduction there. But nothing major to, you know, worry about on that one for sure.
Melanie Faulkner on floor for William and Mary. She's been in the floor lineup the last two meets now. This will be her third in a row after starting the year as a beam specialist.
Yeah, and I know William and Mary was at Westchester on Friday for Westchester's, you know, record-breaking evening, and I think they're coming into this meet a little hungry, trying to maybe have a little bit of a rematch up against the Golden Rams. So definitely, again, keeping an eye on kind of what's happening between those teams.
That was a meet where Westchester came from behind with that beam rotation, and the third rotation helped them come all the way back to the point where they were right in behind William and Mary, ended up overtaking them in the fourth rotation by a tenth.
Summer Rusky up for Temple on vault.
Yurchenko full.
Really nice. Summer always has great height, great distance. You can tell she's been more seasoned on that event. She's able to find that landing and just had a tiny little hop. Maybe one of those like quarter tenth, half tenth hops. So really, really great vault for Summer.
So far the scores that are in for Temple on vault, led by Amelia Budd, 9.775. Peyton Monk had a 9.75. And Hannah Weckler, 9.725. Only score reporting on the other events, Natalie Marshall, a leadoff 9.65 on beam for Westchester. On bars, Logan Hinson for LIU.
Huge single bar release that Yeager direct shoot over was great. Giant full dismount. Able to get up, one step on the dismount, but a solid hit routine.
Sarah Eskew, meanwhile, falling off the beam for Westchester. Renee Shugman on vault.
Our first senior owl of the day. Yurchenko full, just a small hop. Special night, afternoon more for Renee and a few other gymnasts that we'll see throughout the day from Temple. Their last time performing here in McGonigal Hall.
And a really good crowd today as well for the seniors. Madeline Frazier now starting her routine on floor for William and Mary. Round off back handspring to a double tuck. Mackenzie Aresta in the anchor spot for Temple on vault, and very similar, it looks like, rotation to what they had on Thursday afternoon, right, where the form was pretty good throughout, but left some room for deductions on the landings.
Absolutely, yeah, and they have such powerful vaulters throughout that Temple lineup with huge height, distance, Yurchenko fulls. I think they're all just looking to find those sticks to really get a couple of those tens back, but you know, the scores are climbing. Summer Rusky, her score came through 9.825, which is a great sort of build as they headed into the second half of that lineup. Mackenzie Aresta, also a fellow senior, a specialist over there on vault. I believe she may be exhibitioning another event tonight, but that will be her final, truly final performance here in McGonigal.
This is Madison Whitaker on the beam for Westchester. She was one of those new career highs on Friday, 9.825. She's gone 9.725 or better now in five straight meets. Annalisa Page on bars, getting ready for the double lay.
And that was the last exhibition vault up on the top left for Temple. Madison Durunda, Yurchenko layout half, really nicely done.
See, we've switched over to the try box now. That vault is complete. Two more spots to go in the LIU bar lineup. Three more in the William & Mary floor lineup. And two to go on Westchester's beam lineup, which is kind of getting into the teeth of that lineup. Caroline Kaskaden and Lily McFarland, both with very high scores in that come-from-behind win on Friday for the Golden Rams. Kaskaden with a school record 9-9 will be up next. Here is Michelle Noe on floor for William & Mary. Had her fourth 9-8 or better of the season on Friday.
Opens up with a punch front, Rudy. Nicely done. Hitting those 180 degree marks in those leaps. That's one of the, you know, the easiest ways for gymnasts to lose a couple tenths is to, you know, have some of those leaps and jumps in those split positions that aren't at a full 180 degrees.
Second acro pass here, 1.5 front lay.
Beautiful.
Lauren Miller, meanwhile, on bars for LIU. Just came off, coming off a season high against Bowling Green on Sunday of 9.75, but will be the second fall in this lineup for the Sharks. So they'll have to count one of those. There's Caroline Kaskaden on beam for Westchester. School record 9-9 on Friday. We mentioned all five of their counting scores were career highs, led by Kaskaden.
Beautiful handspring layout step out. I love the confidence that she brings to this routine. She's really owning every pose, every jump. No hesitation, which is always great to see. And I'm always envious of beam workers that can make it seem so easy, like Caroline is doing.
Beautiful full turn. Beam lineup that has been on fire back to back, 49 plus, 49-1-5 on Friday.
Round off 1.5, gets a stick. Team is pumped up about it, as they should be. Now they are battling. They did have a fall earlier in the lineup, so a little bit of pressure coming up for Lily McFarland in their anchor spot. Don't want to be counting that falling score, so she'll be up kind of a must-hit situation for the end of this Westchester lineup.
Yeah, you get the feeling, though, with the back end of this Westchester lineup, they are much less worried about having to count a fall the way that the end of their lineup on Beam has performed. Millie McFarland tied a career high on Friday. She's up next. This is Grace Costello on floor for William & Mary.
And we're starting to see some scores trickle in from floor and bars. A little slower to get those uploaded this afternoon, but Sid Morris did kick off that LIU bar lineup with a 9-8-5. They've had a couple little falls and, you know, kind of bumps in the rest of their lineup.
That's Morris at 9-8-5, Annalisa Page at 9-8, Kate Parks at 9-7. Here is Brisa Carrero, career high 9-9-5 on Sunday.
Unfortunately, kind of overshoots on that half pirouette came off. Her connection absolutely beautiful until then, though.
So LIU's going to have to count two falls. Meanwhile, Lily McFarland on Beam needs a hit so that Westchester doesn't have to count a fall in this first rotation.
Round off 1.5 dismount, little shuffle of the feet, but keeps it on the beam.
Meanwhile, William & Mary's gone 5-for-5 on its floor lineup so far, so they will not have to count any sort of low scores. This has been one of their better events in recent meets, at least. Season high on Friday at 48-7 after a slow start to the season in this event.
And as we're waiting for these last couple gymnasts to wrap up here, you can see that Temple vault score, 48.925, definitely an improvement from Thursday. They hit a 48.5 on Thursday, so jumped up, you know, north of 0.4 there. So I think Coach Steele has to feel happy about that. Again, they're going 6-for-6, doing their job, so it's good to see them kind of skim that 49 over on vault.
They get a couple of 9-8s in there as well. Summer Rusky, 9-8-2-5. Renee Shugman with a 9-8. So that's a positive development as we near the end of the regular season. This is Kara Vargo exhibitioning on beam for Westchester.
And kind of a mix of scores thus far for William & Mary on floor. We've seen a 9-8 come in for Hannah Burke, a 9-7-5 for Melanie Faulkner, and a 9-5-7-5 for Madeline Frazier. So having solid hits over on floor, seeing if they can maybe grab a couple other of those higher 9-7, 9-8 scores, I think is probably what they're hoping for.
Yeah, and Westchester is not going to have to count a fall, but they will have to count a lower score. Their high score, Carolyn Kaskinen at 9-8-2-5, and their low score they're going to have to count is a 9-3-7-5 for Madison Whitaker. So you see the 48-2-7-5 is going to be their score on beam after going 49-1-5 on Friday. This is our last counting routine of the first rotation. Sophie Chandler on floor for the Tribe of William & Mary.
Opened up with a round-off double pike, a little unique. You often, you know, see the girls add that back handspring, and she took that out. Just a personal preference, I think. Immediately followed by a round off double tuck.
Yeah.
playing some party jams over on floor. Back one and a half front layout expertly stays in bounds. Beautifully done, wrapped up for the Tribe over there on floor.
That's wonderful spatial recognition at the end of that last pass.
Absolutely, it is not easy.
So that's a solid start for William and Mary on floor. They'll go 6 for 6. We'll wait to see if they have an exhibition. Summer Penzi was listed as a potential exhibition for Kelsey Hinton's Tribe. Kelsey Hinton in her fifth season as the head coach for William and Mary, and it does look like they are setting up for Summer Penzi to exhibition. We'll get you the scores as they come in. You can see the overall team scores. We've got 5 of the 6 scores reported for William and Mary on floor, led by Michelle Noh at 9825. So they'll have 2 9-8s in that lineup, with Noh at 9825 and Hannah Burke at 9-8.
Yeah, and with all scores in, Long Island looks like they are coming in with that 48-375. And I do believe this is actually Sophie Chandler is the exhibition. It was a punch front double full. Unfortunately sat that one down. But in exhibition, no harm, no foul, does not count towards the team score. A front full to a front tuck as the second pass. Last pass, front Rudy, a little off-centered, but makes it to her feet, and officially wraps things up for the Tribe over on floor.
All right, so ready to go for our second rotation in just a few moments from Philadelphia. It'll be William and Mary to vault, Temple on bars, LIU to beam, and Westchester on the floor exercise when we come back. Back in Philadelphia for today's Sunday afternoon quad meet between Temple, Westchester, LIU, and William and Mary. Lauren, this Westchester team coming off of a tremendous day on Friday against William and Mary. Here's what they did on beam. We told you this before. All 5 counting scores were career highs en route to a new program record, 49-15.
Yeah, it was an incredibly impressive night on Friday, and watching them here live today, they have incredible difficulty, a lot of great confidence on the event. Didn't quite hit that 49-15 today, but it was great to see, kind of those highlights still popping up. Great gymnastics over on beam from the Golden Rams.
So the Golden Rams moved to floor in the second rotation. Meanwhile, the team that started on floor had its best day of the season on that event, William and Mary, coming in with a career high mark on floor of 48-85. This is a team that started the year really struggling on floor. They opened the season sub 47, were just a tick above 47 in their second meet of the year, have started to build their scores, and after a season high on Friday at 48-7, they bested 48-85 to start today.
Yeah, they went 6-for-6. Everything looked great over on floor. And as I mentioned, I think at the Open, I got the sense that they were unsatisfied with their loss on Friday against Westchester. So I think they're coming in with a little bit of fire, and they're really bringing it. Slotted themselves into second place after the first rotation.
Yeah, as you mentioned, this is a quad meet that is really two different conference duels, right? Because William and Mary and Westchester in the Gymnastics East Conference, and Temple and LIU in the Eagle. Westchester, by the way, their start to this season, as we now close in on conference championship season, they are fourth in the A-team GSC, which puts them in position for the second session at GEC Championships up at Yale in a couple of weeks. They'll open with Grace Costello on the vault in their first spot in their lineup. Meanwhile, as the warm-up gets underway, the beam lineup for LIU is one that we'll have to watch in this rotation because, Lauren, they have been tremendous all year. It's by far their best event, 49 or better four times this season, with an anchor in Sid Morris, who is ranked 11th in NCAA on beam.
Yeah, I really liked their level of difficulty on bars. Unfortunately, I think had to count a fall over there on bars. But I've been excited to see their beam lineup and see kind of what they can put together coming off that bar rotation and going into their best event.
So we'll see LIU on beam, Westchester on floor, Temple on bars, and William and Mary on vault when we return. All right, back at McGonigal Hall in Philadelphia, Andrew Loftglass alongside Lauren Capone-Porzio for our second rotation of the day. William and Mary to vault, Temple over to bars, LIU to its best event on beam, and Westchester will head over to the floor exercise. Let's talk about Temple a little bit before we get started with this this second rotation. Bars this year, a little bit up and down at the start, but they matched their season high on Thursday, 48-5. What are you looking for from this lineup today?
Yeah, it's definitely a younger lineup that has sort of had to find its footing throughout this season. And I think that they finally started to find a rhythm and really start to hone in on, you know, these six gymnasts putting their best performances out there when they get to these meets. So I'm really excited to see it. Like you mentioned, kind of a really strong bar performance on Thursday, and I would love to see them best it a little bit, and I think they can. I think it's going to come down to some form things and really, really looking for those dismount sticks and good landings as they kind of go top to bottom here on the lineup.
That Thursday score was an important bounce back for them because they had to count two falls in the prior meet, a season low 47-75. And Hillary Steele, first-year head coach of the Owls, said that, you know, Thursday's performance is pretty much what we should expect out of this lineup because maybe they're a little bit young and there are a few form things to clean up. It might be tough for them to get to that 49-plus unless it's an exceptional day. So you land at a 48.95, and that's a really good day.
Yeah, and led by Sarah Stallings, had a career-high 9.9 on Thursday, so would love to just copy and paste that for this afternoon for sure. But getting things started here with Reese DeHaan, who's been a great leadoff for this lineup thus far this season. Pike Yeager, immediate shootover. I couldn't tell from my angle if her feet touched coming through, but dismount, double tuck, gets a stick. It was hard to tell if her feet did in fact skim a little bit on coming out of that shootover. It'll be a little bit of a deduction that might reflect in, you know, maybe a lower score despite, or, you know, what is a fully hit routine for Reese. She had a 9.725 on Thursday. Getting some other events going here. Beam and floor lighten up.
Kale Bixler on floor on beam for LIU. School record on Sunday on this event, 9.975.
Handspring, handspring layout, step out to open up. Beautifully done. Takes up the full length of the beam. Thank you.
Corinne Gruber on floor for Westchester.
Yeah, Westchester, I think, looking to get some tents back on this floor rotation.
Grace Costello on vault. Yurchenko tuck full.
Nicely done. Just a little bit of a chest down on her landing. Takes that step to the side. Looks like we're pausing over on bars to have a judges conference. A little bit of a difference in scores there between the two.
That's about the moment you flagged where her feet might have clipped the low bar.
Yes, it definitely could be. I'm seeing a 9.45 and I think it was a 9.7. So, you know, most times the judges just average the two scores, but if they seem to be a little bit far from one another, the judges can meet and kind of review their deductions, review the bonus points they counted or did not count. Little bit of extra waiting for Hannah Weckler, who was ready to go up second there for the Owls.
A little bit of extra time for her to think and prepare. She did have the one fall for Temple in their lineup on Thursday. Sarah Cooper on vault for William and Mary. Yurchenko layout half.
Nicely done, just a step on the dismount.
Meanwhile, Annalisa Page on beam for LIU.
Kale Bixler opened up with a 9.75, so a great starting score for the Long Island lineup on beam. Handspring layout step out right up, nothing on that. Hannah Weckler finally gets the go-ahead over on bars. Beautiful Shaposh. Down to the low bar for the bail. Great final handstand. Giant full double tuck. And gets a stick. Huge routine for Hannah. That's definitely the best I've seen her do this season. Great job.
Phenomenal bounce back for her. You mentioned she hit that bail. That's where she missed on Thursday. And sometimes you hit that one skill that you missed last time, and it sets you free for the rest of the event.
Absolutely. Nothing feels better than that, than, you know, meet after you kind of have that type of mistake and really nailing it.
Sophia Wong, layout full on vault.
Beautiful shape in the air, just a little bouncy on the landing. I think almost didn't know how good she had it in the air there. But really impressive stuff over from the tribe over on vault. Lots of variety in their vaults, and they look really, really good.
This is Lily McFarland in the second spot of the Westchester floor lineup wrapping up.
A big cheer over from the sort of bars peanut gallery for Temple. I think that was a 9.85 for Hannah Weckler, one judge giving her a 9.9. So huge performance setting up Angelina Hogan.
So if that's the score, 9.85, that is a new career high for the freshman. Weckler's previous career high was a 9.8. And here is Angie Hogan. She matched her career high Thursday at 9.725.
Toe hand to bail, nicely done. That little circle around the bar, okay for the gymnast to do. Giant fold double tuck. And another stick, getting contagious over on bars.
Back-to-back owl sticks from Weckler and Hogan. Meanwhile, Caroline Blatchford on vault for William and Mary. Yurchenko tuck full, just landed a little chest down there.
Seeing some good scores come in though for William and Mary on vault. Sarah Cooper had a 9.75. Grace Costello opened with a 9.65.
This is Katie Bills McCoy, the freshman on beam for LIU. Strong triple series until she just lost her grip on that beam at the last second.
Yeah, it looked like her back foot, like she kind of went to replace it and it just slipped and took her right off.
Sarah Eskew on floor for Westchester.
Yeah, coming out swinging, Westchester. Corinne Gruber did kick things off with a 9.85 as the leadoff. So, as I mentioned, Westchester fighting for those tenths back.
Hannah Burke on vault, layout half. Big layout half, and looked like she couldn't control the landing.
Yeah, took that step forward.
Sarah Eskew, really nice on floor today. She had entered this lineup for Barbara Cordova's Golden Rams only in the middle of February and has been pretty consistent in that 9-7 range since then, but coming off a 9-1 on Friday. So that's now 3-for-3 for Westchester and pretty strong scores on floor, leading into Christina Rodriguez, who tied her career high on Friday at 9-8.
Yeah, like I mentioned, really strong scores already for Westchester. Kind of trickling in on floor. A 9-8 and a 9.85. Not a bad way to start your floor lineup.
Beam scores for LIU. Kale Bixler 9.75. Annalisa Page with a 9.05. And so they're going to have to count at least one low score on balance beam after counting two low scores on bars. Anne-Marie Kubler wrapping up on vault for William and Mary. And here's Emily Johnson on bars for Temple.
So far, so good for Emily. This double layout dismount. Nicely done, just took a step. And I think actually Coach Steele mentioned this to you, that double lay dismount for Emily, she almost pikes it down a little bit when she doesn't have to. And I think she kind of did the same thing. But again, another hit routine for Temple over on bars. They're moving really well over on that event.
That little pike position, you think, led to that small shuffle forward?
I think so, yeah. I think if, you know, kind of keeping that body shape and really pulling the rotation around and spotting that stick, being a little more confident in that landing will come with experience for sure.
Brisa Carrero now on beam for LIU, the Argentinian national team member. Three of her five performances this year have been 9.8 or better. And Christina Rodriguez, we mentioned before, on floor. Career high on Friday, 9.8.
And I did see Christina did step out of bounds on her first pass, so she will get an automatic 1/10 deduction from her final score. Beautiful work over on beam, round off, 1.5 stuck. That was an incredible beam set.
That was Sophie Chandler exhibitioning on vault, by the way, for William and Mary.
Sarah Stallings over on bars. Pike Yeager.
Coming off her career high Thursday of a 9.9.
Yeah, beautiful bail to handstand. She's got great toe point. always accentuates things really nicely. Giant full, double tuck. The tiniest of hops, beautifully done. I'm loving this bar lineup from Temple. They're doing great.
William and Mary has to be quite pleased with its vault lineup today as well, with no scores under 9725. Check that. Looks like we're getting an update on vault for William and Mary. So I apologize. Looking at the live stats and got it wrong. So their scores, 9-7-5 for Sarah Cooper and for Hannah Burke are the leaders. And then Sophia Wong, 9-6-7-5. Grace Costello and Caroline Blatchford each with 9-6-5. And then Anne-Marie Kubler at 9-5. Meanwhile, on beam for LIU, this is Alana Ricketts.
Front aerial beat jump. Alana, beautiful lines. Handspring layout, step out. One of those captivating beam performers that makes it all look so easy. Switch leap, switch leap.
She'll go back handspring, back tuck 1.5.
Just a step on the dismount, and honestly, that was really the only thing I saw in that beam routine. And you see the score pop up for Brisa, a 9-9, which is well-deserved, really impressive bar routine, or beam routine, pardon me.
So 9-9 on beam for Carrero. That is a new career high for the freshman, who previously had gone 9-8-5 for her career high. Serena Whalen, the anchor on bars for Temple, and just fighting to keep those feet on the mat.
A beautiful bar worker, great routine, celebrating her senior day here in McGonagall Hall. She's been such a strong anchor to this bar lineup with high difficulty, beautiful gymnastics on bars. A great way to close out a really, really strong bar lineup this afternoon.
This is Kylie Fred in the fifth spot on the Westchester floor lineup, by the way. She has been a constant in Barbara Cordova's floor lineup this year. Now you're going to want to keep your eyes on the beam, where Sid Morris has proven to be one of the best in the nation this year, 11th ranked beam worker in the country. For the sophomore, boasting a program record 9.975. They've gone 9.9 or better 6 of 7 times this season.
Yeah, absolutely one to watch. 11th in the nation is no joke. Switch leap, pike jump. Back handspring layout, step out. I think it's clear you can see Sid really kind of brings her own personality and energy to her beam work. Side summy.
They'll have this pike jump with a half turn.
Super unique. I think judges always like to see a little bit of uniqueness in a routine, get a little bit of reward for that when you can nail it.
So smooth and clean so far. Back double full.
Gives it a head nod because she knew it was a solid hit. She's pumped up about it as she should be. Beautiful beam work. And I think we'll see another big score. Great lineup for LIU over on beam, as anticipated.
They get a 9-9 from Carrero, a 9-8-2-5 from Alana Ricketts, which is just shy of Alana's career high in her senior year. And we'll wait to see the score that is thrown for Sid Morris. They hit 5 out of 6 in that lineup. Caroline Kaskinen in the anchor spot on floor for Westchester.
Yeah, Westchester absolutely rolling over on floor. Their lowest score, a 9-5-7-5. As I mentioned, Christina Rodriguez had that step out of bounds, so she had that automatic 1/10 deduction. So I think that will be the score that they are looking to drop at this point.
Kaskinen had a 9-8-2-5 on beam earlier. Friday was only the second time all year she's gone 9-8 on both of her events, beam and floor. So she can do it for a third time and a second time this week if she hits this floor line, this floor routine.
Yeah, as I mentioned, this is such a fun time for NCAA gymnastics because kind of you've moved past the preseason kinks you've worked out and you're edging towards championship season. So things are really getting clean and edging towards perfect. So it's great to see it. There's a lot of high energy because of that.
Taylor Doten on beam exhibition for LIU. So we'll see what score Kaskinen gets, if it's another 9-8 or better. Looks like they are setting up for an exhibition on floor as well. Bridget Sullivan is scheduled exhibition for the Golden Rams.
Yeah, it looks like Sid Morris did clock in a 9-9 as well, so tying Brisa Carrero's score there. So a pair of 9-9s for LIU.
So that makes it for Morris 7 for 8 this year, hitting 9-9 or better.
Yeah, I think, you know, she'll be one to watch as we get into regionals. You know, LIU may not be qualifying as a team to the regional competition, but individuals are able to qualify. And I think being 11th in the nation, she won't have an issue there. So it'll be fun to see kind of where she takes it in the postseason.
And they qualified for the NCAA regionals last year as an all-arounder. Two-time Eagle Gymnast of the Week this year. They were Rookie of the Year in the Eagle last year. Here is Bridget Sullivan.
Front Rudy to an immediate jump. Front lay, front full. Well done to close things out for Westchester. Good to see some depth, and Westchester having an awesome performance on floor. They hit over 49.175. It looks like with just a bevy of 9-8 and above scores. They dropped that 9.575 from the cheers. I do believe that maybe at least I feel like they're season high on the event. So rolling right along for Westchester. But a great second rotation across the board for all teams. Temple hit over 49 on bars. So we are shaping up really well after this second rotation for sure.
You got it right, Westchester, a season high on floor 49.175, their second 49 or better in that event this year. So they had a program record on beam on Friday. They get a season high on floor today. Temple in the lead through two rotations. We'll come back with rotation number 3 from McGonigal Hall when we return. the start of our third rotation from McGonigal Hall in Philadelphia. Temple in the lead through two rotations with that 9-8-0-5 and coming off of a season-high performance on bars, their first 49-plus on bars this year. Let's take a look at Sid Morris, who once again, Lauren, was phenomenal on beam, as we have come to expect. That's Sid's resume, and it's hard to beat.
Yeah, it's so impressive watching the gymnastics they've put together this season. And as you mentioned, being that 11th in the nation on beam, that was the first time I've gotten to see that routine in person, and it sure does deserve it. It was clean, hardly a mistake, and they do compete in the all-around, so we get to see all four events, and I think we're going to see a lot in the postseason from Sid.
Sid with a 9.85 on bars, a 9.9 on beam, has been the Eagle Gymnast of the Week twice now this year, and coming off of a season high in the all-around, 39.4 on Sunday against Bowling Green. We'll see what is in store. Coming up in our third rotation, Sid and the Sharks go to floor, William and Mary to bars, Temple on beam, Westchester on vault. And for our third rotation of the day in this quad meet, and Temple on top after a terrific performance on bars. It was their best performance of the year. They were just shy of a 49 on vault, 48.925. And on bars, 49.125 for their first 49 or better of the year. It comes after matching their season high, which was just sub 49 on Thursday. They had 48.95 with one fall on Thursday. Of course, didn't have to count a fall, but still had to battle through that. And even better today as we near conference championship season.
Yeah, there was a trio of 9.85s in that lineup. Hannah Weckler, freshman with a career high with that 9.85, beautiful set. Sarah Stallings and Serena Whalen all coming in with that 9.85 mark, and well-deserved. As I kind of mentioned before bar started, I thought that they could give just a little bit more and inch themselves over that 49 mark. So I was happy to see it, and it was well-deserved. I think that the team should be really happy heading into this beam lineup, where now they kind of have to slow things down a little bit. Having a great afternoon, and you want to keep that momentum rolling, but beam, a very intense event, kind of making sure that they're staying in their bubble, I'm sure is exactly what Coach Hillary Steele is saying right now, to not get too ahead of themselves. As they go through this beam lineup patiently, doing exactly what they know how to do. It's a great event for the Owls. They have the potential to score very high. Another event where they haven't quite hit that 49 mark yet this season, coming as close as 48.975 as the season high thus far. So we will see how the Owls can put it together on beam today.
So in this third rotation, Westchester to vault, William and Mary to bars, Temple on beam, and LIU goes to the floor exercise. On beam to lead off for Temple is Peyton Monk. 3 9.825s or better in this lineup on Thursday for a 48.9. It was their second highest score of the season. On bars, Sarah Cooper for William and Mary, and Bridget Sullivan just leading off on vault for Westchester, which, by the way, has to be tough because she exhibitioned on floor to close last rotation.
I'd still be out of breath. For Peyton over on beam, a little bit of a wobble over on her opening series. But I've been very impressed with Peyton as a freshman coming in, and being the leadoff on beam is no easy task. No issues on the side aerial there.
That's Alina Danilchenko leading off on floor for LIU.
And keeps it on her feet on the dismount over on beam. Peyton wraps things up, just a step on that punch front full. A couple things here and there, but she kicked off the lineup with a hit, so all you can ask for.
Danilchenko has been the picture of consistency in the leadoff this year for the Sharks. Has only gone below 9.7 twice in seven meets this year.
First time competing, though, since the end of February at Towson.
Yeah, she's definitely got the kind of the eyes of the audience on her. She's got super dramatic music. It's really cool. Double pike. Right up, no issues.
That was Christina Rodriguez on vault for Westchester. Westchester, by the way, we mentioned this at the end of the last rotation, coming off of a season high on floor, 49-175, after their program record on beam on Friday. On bars, this is Ashel Laird for William & Mary.
Hand slipped off on that bail, but it was a really great connection. Unfortunately, I do believe that will count as a fall. Going into this giant fold, double tuck, and ends up putting the knee down there on that dismount as well.
Yeah, as Sarah Cooper did in the leadoff on her dismount, unfortunately. Summer Ruskey on beam for Temple.
Really nice series for Summer. I just caught no movement, super aggressive, which was great to see. Front toss, nicely done. It's been great to see Summer's sort of improvement in confidence over the time that I've kind of seen her. She's really come into her own on beam, especially to be a really strong performer.
Lily McFarland just finished her vault for Westchester. Second spot in the LIU floor lineup, this is Annalisa Page.
Summer ends with that back handspring, back 1.5, fought for that landing, but another really strong hit. And LIU did open with a 9.85 on floor, so big, again, starting off strong on floor for a lot of these gymnasts today. It's great.
That is just shy of the freshman Danilchenko's season high. 9.875 was her best.
Great double tuck in that second pass. Nicely done over on floor. A stuck Yurchenko layout over on vault for Westchester.
By Corinne Gruber. And now it's Madison DeRonda on beam, just fighting to stay on the beam in that third spot in their lineup.
Yeah, that triple series is beautiful. She had the tiniest of bobbles, but she pulled up really well, keeping things moving.
She was all eagle on this event a year ago.
Cartwheel back 1.5. Just the hop on the dismount. Nicely done.
Temple on beam, the only score reporting so far is Peyton Monk, 9.625. Lauren Miller for LIU on floor. Bottom right of your screen. Really energetic routine. She's got a season high she's coming off of on Sunday.
9875.
Yeah, opened with a great double pike.
Jordan Coleman, fifth spot in the Westchester vault lineup.
Another Yurchenko layout, just a small step.
And now Tori Sipes looking to be the first to hit on bars for William and Mary. She's the third in this lineup. Nice handstand, gearing up for the dismount. Double A.
Renee Shugman getting started on beam for Temple, continuing her senior day. Front aerial, front handspring.
One and a half.
Couple shuffles of the feet back.
Sarah Eskew on vault for Westchester to wrap up their lineup there. And it sounds like we've got a score reporting down on bars for William and Mary that we can't quite make out from our angle. For Tori Sipes, that'll be their first hit routine of the afternoon on bars.
Yeah, a couple bumps for the tribe over on bars. But as they're getting into sort of this back half of their lineup, putting some strong routines together. Huge Dukachev, straight to a bail. Nice connection.
By Catherine Bear.
Giant full, double tuck. And just a small step, great routine, getting some energy back for the tribe over on bars.
Alana Ricketts on floor for LIU. Getting sent to start. Coming off a season high 9.85 or second 9.8 or better on this event. Hannah Shelton, meanwhile, exhibitioning on vault for Westchester.
Oh, a fall over on floor for Long Island. Just over-rotated that double tuck. So that will be the routine that the Sharks are going to look to drop at this point. They're doing great thus far until that error.
That aforementioned bar score for William and Mary, Tori Sipes, 9.825 is the score reporting. So that is a new career high for Sipes. Brooke Donabedian now on beam for Temple.
Front aerial back handspring, nicely done. She had a tiny little wobble on her leap jump series. I'm seeing just little tiny things from Temple over on beam. Beautiful side summy. Round off 1.5. Small hop on the dismount. Keeping things on their feet over on beam.
Caroline Blatchford starting on bars for William and Mary.
Beautiful opening handstand and lines. Straddle Jaeger, immediate shoot over. Nicely done.
Line full. Double tuck.
Huge. The back half of this, you know, William and Mary lineup on bars has really brought it, and not in an easy position. Always tough to have some of your teammates fall and kind of be trying to pull ahead from behind, but they're putting together some amazing gymnastics.
Three nice performances in a row. Tori Sipes with that career high 9.825. By the way, in her grad year, so hitting a career high at the back end of your grad year, pretty impressive. Her previous career high on bars was a 9.725. So 9.825 in her performance today. And now Sarah Stallings in the anchor on beam for Temple.
Handspring, handspring, layout, step out. A little bit of a fidget with the back leg, but keeps everything up. Split straddle quarter. Round off 1.5, and a step back. And Temple goes 6 for 6 on beam, just looking for landings, I think. I think my takeaway kind of from the 6 counting routines that we saw is just kind of those little things that add up, right? Making sure you're sticking landings and not letting a foot shuffle on a series or a leap pass. So, but all in all, there's nothing more you can ask for than 6 for 6.
Yeah, the little things to clean up, I think, are those landings, and they still cleaned up one of the issues that they've had this year, which is some little connection errors that have been much better today than they've been in meets past.
Absolutely.
Sarah Wozniak in the anchor spot on bars for William and Mary, and this is Ella Barrington on floor for LIU. Double lay from Wozniak, a little shuffle forward, but otherwise that's 4 straight very strong routines on bars for the Tribe.
Yeah, really impressive as they sort of had that rough start, but were able to pull together some really strong performances in the end for them.
First 2 lineup spots were falls, and since then, Sipes, Bear, Blatchford, and Wozniak have all hit.
We'll have 2 senior day exhibitions over on beam for Temple. Mackenzie Aresta up first. We saw her on vault earlier. But getting a chance to do her beam routine one last time here. Handspring layout, step out.
As a senior, by the way, debuting on beam this year, you do not see that very often, to crack the beam lineup for the first time as a senior.
Yeah, Mackenzie's been a great specialist, you know, at her time here, and I think senior days are always so special because, you know, even if you just get the chance to do the routines that you've been doing in the gym all the time, even just this once kind of in front of a home crowd is super special.
A steady vault specialist throughout her career.
Back cantering, back 1.5 with a hop.
Nine, 8.5 is the score being thrown for Sarah Wozniak on bars for William and Mary. Saw a little cheer. That matches a career high for the junior. That'll put her in a tie with Sid Morris for the event lead as well, with Morris, Weckler, Stallings, and Whalen all knotted for first on bars. They're gonna have an exhibition here as well.
Sid Morris getting started over on floor. Certainly another one to watch.
Madeline Frazier, the exhibition for William & Mary. We talk all about Sid Morris on beam. They've also tied the LIU program record on floor, 9925, this past Sunday.
Huge double tuck. Artistry from Sid throughout this routine. Similar to their work on beam, just tons of personality woven throughout, in addition to some really high skill. Front layout, front full, a little slide of the back foot, but nothing major. Serena Whalen getting started with her exhibition on beam as Sid is finishing up. Double pike. Beautiful finish for Sid, beautiful series for Serena.
See how excited Sid and her teammates are about that. Remember, an all-arounder who is coming off of a season high in the all-around, 39-4 against Bowling Green, and has had a strong start today. A 9.85 on bars and a 9.9 on beam to lead both events.
Cartwheel back 1.5 for Serena. Sits it down, but no harm, no foul in the exhibitions.
Yeah, really the only thing you're concerned about with errors in the exhibition is athlete health. And so as long as she's all right following that fall, then all is well and good.
She let out a little chuckle. So I think she was just happy to be able to get that beam routine out in McGonagall, you know, one last time. She's been a consistent sort of alternate exhibition for that beam lineup, never been the consistent lineup member, but she's got beautiful work on beam, so it was great to see.
Anne-Marie Kubler on bars for William & Mary in their second exhibition. We'll get one more floor exhibition as well for LIU before we wrap up. Give us a chance to check scores.
Giant full double tuck. Makes it on her feet, fought through that routine really well. Build some confidence in an exhibition slot.
So team scores, you see the scores totals in your bottom right as we see our exhibition for LIU on floor. This is Kira Sanchez. Temple on beam 48-6. Is their beam score.
You'll see Sid Morris 9.85 to close out that lineup, which they were able to drop the one fall they had in that lineup. Bumps them up to that 145.85 for their team score through three.
And just shy of a 49 on floor, 48.975. They're coming off the season high 49.225 last Sunday. William & Mary 48.875 on bars, and for Westchester on vault 48.35.
Double pike. That one step back, so long as it is under control, is no deduction. So kind of dissimilar to other events where taking a step gives you a deduction on floor, whether you're going forwards or backwards, you are allowed to take one controlled step with no deduction, which is obviously up to judges' discretion if it is controlled or not.
How controlled is that lunge is in the eye of the beholder, but on an exhibition, a very nice performance by Kira Sanchez. And that will send us into the fourth and final rotation for our quad meet today, with Temple in the lead, 146-65 on senior day. The Owls will go to the floor exercise, Westchester to bars, LIU to vault, William and Mary on beam when we come back. Fourth rotation from Philadelphia. Back for our fourth and final rotation from McGonigal Hall, the senior day quad meet for Temple. They are in the lead, 146-65 over Eagle rival Long Island, and the two schools from the Gymnastics East Conference, Westchester and William and Mary. In total score order, it's Temple, William and Mary, followed by LIU and Westchester. Pretty close for third and fourth today. Here is what Temple has done this year under first-year head coach Hillary Steele. They're coming off of another 195-5. You see what they did on Temple Alumni Night, 195-9. They need a 48 in order to match what they did on Thursday. They need a 49-3 to best their Temple Alumni Night score, their season high for the year.
And if they're going to do it on any event, it is floor. It really has been consistently a strong event for Temple this year. As you can see, that Temple alumni, the eighth best team score in program history, really strong all-around effort on that night. And, you know, they're looking pretty good this afternoon. Vault and bars, strong improvement from Thursday. Beam going 6-for-6 with just some little things that they can look to clean up as, you know, next weekend, one more meet, and then we're headed to Eagle Championships. So really is crunch time, but you're seeing the best of the best from these athletes, and especially a special night for the senior athletes from Temple competing here in McGonigal Hall for the last time. Brooke Donabedian, Renee Shugman, you'll see in this floor lineup celebrating their final performances.
And seem to be trending well on their way to their third 195 or better in the last four meets. We will have that fourth rotation with the Owls on floor when we come back. Great crowd today at McGonigal Hall in Philadelphia for our gymnastics quad meet and senior day. Temple in the lead through three rotations over LIU, Westchester, and William and Mary. Hey, the folks from Long Island showing up and showing out. Short drive over to Philadelphia today, and they've seen LIU compete well this afternoon in third place of the four teams, and the homestanding Owls, they didn't have to travel too far, and they too left their shirts in the dorm rooms.
A lot of body paint in that crowd today, more than I anticipated seeing. But we are gearing up for a floor party here in McGonigal Hall. Nothing beats the home team on floor. I think every team gets excited to have that moment at home meets on floor where everyone can get the crowd and Hooter into the mix. A fan favorite.
Getting his customary selfies in ahead of Temple's floor lineup. You mentioned it's always fun to wrap up senior day on floor, and I'm sure everybody looking forward to seeing the two seniors in this lineup, Renee Shugman and Brooke Donabedian, who puts on such an incredible show every time.
Absolutely, yeah, and I've really been impressed with this floor lineup this year. They've, at this point, settled in. They're performing really well, so I'm excited to see them kind of put this together and close out what has been a successful afternoon for Temple.
Now, we mentioned before that they need a 49-3 to set a season high, and they are well on their way to a third 195 or better in their last four meets. So they'll be on floor. Westchester getting set on bars, William and Mary on beam, and LIU on vault. This is Hyla Betts on bars for Westchester.
Yeah, now Temple has really secured themselves in sort of this first place spot, barring any, you know, major catastrophe. So it is going to be interesting to see these other three teams sort of battle for second place in this final rotation.
Good start for Westchester, and Hyla Betts hitting that double layout.
Yeah, strong routine, just a step back.
They had a bounce back on Bars on Friday, 48-425, which was coming off of their worst meet of the year at 46-8 March 2nd at Rutgers. Before that, they hadn't scored below 47-925. Typically very strong and consistent. This is Madison Durunda on floor for Temple.
Opened up with a huge double tuck.
Sarah Cooper on beam for William and Mary.
Work over on beam for William and Mary. That lead off beam performance, so important, really sets the tone for the rest of the lineup. Durunda back on floor, that front layout to Rudy, closes things out. Nicely done.
Cooper coming off of that full turn on beam. She'll have a backhand spring to a 1.5 for her dismount.
Just a small hop.
Kale Bixler on vault for LIU. Yurchenko layout full, it looks like.
Some big cheers over from Temple on floor. I saw 1-9-9 flashed from one judge.
9-9 is the score for Madison Durunda in the leadoff for Temple on floor. That is a career high for the junior.
Christina Rodriguez keeping things going for Westchester on bars. Stuck dismount. Love to see it.
And this is Melanie Faulkner on beam for William and Mary. Anna Weckler on floor for Temple.
She goes punch Rudy, back layout step out. Already having a phenomenal day for Hannah after that career high performance on bars.
Alina Danilchenko on vaults for LIU. Like Faulkner trying to connect that switch leap to the split jump and had a little bit of a delay. Not sure she'll get that connection bonus.
Weckler back 1.5 layout. Beautifully done. It's always good to see when that second flip, so the front layout after the back 1.5 rises higher than the first. Really good stuff. Great day for the freshman today. I think she can kick her feet up this evening with a big smile on her face. She's done incredibly well at this last home meet of the season.
Hannah Weckler had a 9.85 on bars. That was a career high. 9.725 on vault. Should score very well on that floor routine. Annalisa Page on vault for LIU.
Oh, Sid Morris, actually, on vault, pardon. Great Yurchenko layout full, and a great day for Sid.
We'll see what the final score is for Sid in the all-around. He's been fantastic this year when competing all four events. 39-4 against Bowling Green Sunday. It's Melanie Ringus on bars for Westchester.
Gearing up for the dismount. Stuck double A. getting some contagious sticks from the Golden Rams over on bars, building a lot of energy. And a huge 9.875 for Hannah Weckler just got flashed, setting up Renee Shugman.
Caroline Blatchford on beam for William and Mary as well.
Triple series, a little bit of a bobble. Back 1.5, front 1.5 for Renee Shugman, who's been in and out of this floor lineup a little bit, just tending to some, as I would call it, old age wear and tear for senior gymnasts. But certainly not slowing her down as of right now. First pass looked great.
Qualified for the NCAA Regionals last year on floor.
She's just been incredibly consistent in her time at Temple. Rock solid in every event that she's been on. And a great leader, I think, for kind of this next wave of Temple Owl gymnasts. Front layout, front full. Nicely done.
Hannah Shelton now on bars for Westchester. So that is one of the two seniors wrapping up their home career on floor for Temple. This whole event will close with Brooke Donabedian. Looks like Lauren Miller just wrapping up the LIU vault lineup. So we'll see the scores come in for the Sharks soon.
And another solid hit for Westchester on bars. I saw Sid Morris, 9.825 on vault. Annalisa Page, 9.75.
So for Sid, that is a new season high in the all-around. Barely edging her prior season high. She was at 39.4 on Sunday, 39.425 today.
And another 9.9 coming in for Temple on floor for Renee Shugman, setting up Summer Rusky. That 49.3 maybe not so far out of grasp as we maybe originally thought, but we will have to see as we continue kind of through the back half of the Owls floor lineup.
Madeline Frazier on beam for William and Mary.
Huge opening pass for Rusky. Just a score check in, William and Mary leading so far. Melanie Faulkner had a 9.725 as the highest score. A 9.65 from Sarah Cooper and Caroline Blatchford, 9.625. So pretty steady for the Tribe over on beam, trying to hold on to that second place that they had coming into this last event. Round off 1.5, fights for the stick in that deep squat. Keeping things moving for the Tribe. Last pass for Rusky, double pike. Beautifully done. Floor lineup heating up.
With two more to go, Peyton Monk and Brooke Donabedian. So we'll keep tracking and see how close Temple comes to that new season high score. Sarah Eskew on bars for Westchester.
Has had a little bit of an issue. I think she was going for a single bar release. and had come off once and just jumped off again. Getting some direction from head coach on how to wrap things up.
It's Barbara Cordova in her 17th season as the head coach of the Golden Rams. Michelle No on beam for William and Mary in their fifth lineup spot.
And a huge 9.925 for Summer Rusky.
Another career high.
Setting up Peyton Monk. For those keeping track, so far not a score under 9.875 for this Temple floor lineup. Peyton punch front through to double pike. She's got such a fun routine. I am so impressed that as a freshman, she's really just popped into this floor lineup with great performance quality with, you know, the difficulty and quality of gymnastics to match it.
It's 3.99s or better in this lineup so far. Rusky 9.925, Durunda and Shugman at 9.9. The way things are tracking, Rusky is going to certainly challenge for that event title. She is in the lead right now. Brooke Donabedian, of course, has a history of high scores in this event.
Front double full for Peyton. Beautifully done. McGonagall Hall going absolutely nuts.
Grace Costello and the anchor on beam for William and Mary.
Brooke Donabedian closing things out for the Owls on floor.
Jordan Coleman on bars for Westchester, and for Donabedian, who has been one of the best floor workers for this program in recent memory, this will be her final performance on her home floor.
From 1.5 to a back layout step out, done with style. Beautiful jumps. One more pass for Donna Bedian to close things out for her career here in McGonagall Hall. Front double full, perfectly done. Huge smile.
And what a way to close for Temple on senior day on floor, with the scores reporting now. Peyton Monk and Summer Rusty both with 9.925s. Four scores of 9.9 or better. The worst the Owls can do with a Donna Bedian score is still break an all-time program record on the floor exercise. 49.525 is the current score that can only be improved upon depending on what Donna Bedian does here.
Yeah, that score last year set in February of 2023 by this, you know, same team of a 49.4. So they can celebrate new school team record on floor. Just waiting to see the final score that gets flashed for Donna Bedian.
The current total score, you see, 196-175, would land at the fifth best score in program history, easily the best this year. They hadn't gone above 196 this year, 195-9, their previous season high. So they've certainly broken that.
And it looks to be a third 9.925 for Brooke Donna Bedian, matching Peyton Monk and Summer Rusky.
We have an exhibition on bars, by the way. This is McCarthy Keene. So we'll wait officially on the final score.
That final floor score looks to be a 49.575. Absolutely new school event record there. Counting and all scores of 9.9 and above, they only dropped the 9.875.
That was a heck of a score
Weckler
to drop. And it takes what would have been a 196-175 to a 196-225. Still fifth best score of all time, but just a shade below number four, which is 196-25 from almost a year ago today, last March at Maryland. 196-225. Looks to be your final official score for the Owls, and a record day on floor on senior day, led by a trio of 9.925s. Summer Rusky, Peyton Monk, and the senior Brooke Donna Bedian with 9.9s as well by Madison Durunda and another senior in Renee Shugman. A tremendous, tremendous way to wrap up the senior day celebration in Philadelphia. So we'll take a quick break. We will come right back. When we return, we'll get all your final scores and event winners and close it out on senior day from Philadelphia and McGonagall Hall. McGonagall Hall, and wrapping up the senior day quad meet between Temple, LIU, William & Mary, and Westchester. There are your final scores, and for the Temple Owls on senior day, they post overall the fifth best score in program history, easily their best overall score of the year, boosted by a program record on floor in the final rotation, 49.575, and a season high on bars at 49.125. Also terrific individual event performances for Westchester on floor. They had a season high, 49.175, and overall, William & Mary with a season high overall scored today as well, just a shade below 195, 194.925 for the Tribe, who came in with an NQS of 191.755, so a banner day for the Tribe as well.
Yeah, it was great to see all four of these teams really putting out their best effort. As we've talked about, the entire meet, this is crunch time. We're headed into championship season with only one regular season meet coming up for these teams next weekend. So you're seeing the best. You're seeing inches of shades off of perfection from all of these routines. And I think all of these teams should be super happy. Individual team event performances up and down on all events. It was a great afternoon of gymnastics with Temple really setting the bar high and adding to their record books, not just on the events, but with this overall team score.
So let's quickly take a look at our individual event winners today. Lauren Miller for Long Island wins on vault 985. The winning scores, several of them on bars, all tied at 985. Sid Morris for Long Island, Hannah Weckler, Sarah Stallings, and Serena Whalen for Temple, Sarah Wozniak for William & Mary, and Christina Rodriguez for Westchester. On bars, a pair from Long Island tie with 9-9 scores, Brisa Carrero and Sid Morris. And on floor, three from Temple, all with 9925, Summer Rusky, Peyton Monk, and Brooke Donabedian on the Owls' record-setting performance on the floor exercise. Sid Morris with a season best in the all-around 39425 for the Sharks. So that will do it from a fun and energetic, chaotic quad meet from Philadelphia. Big thanks to our crew. For Lauren Capone Porzio, I'm Andrew Luftglass saying so long from Philadelphia. We'll see you next time.